Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Sacred Heart Church and our Eucharistic celebration. Today we celebrate the Solemnity of All Saints. The readings begin on page 76. At this Mass, we pray in a special way for the repose of the souls of Alma and Ro LeBrock. Together, let us pray our Sacred Heart offering. Sacred Heart of Jesus, filled with infinite love, broken by my ingratitude and pierced by my sins, yet loving me still, accept the gift I make to you of all that this day has been, all that I am, and all that I have. Take every faculty of my soul and body. Only day by day, draw me nearer and nearer to your Sacred Heart, and there, teach me your holy way. Please stand as we begin our Mass and greet our celebrant, Father Mathieu.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you teach us the way of holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus Christ, you gift us with a share of your blessedness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Today the Church celebrates the All Saints, the Solemnity of All Saints. In this Mass, we're going to be praying for the repose of the souls of Alma and Wo Labrec. Almighty ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God who is seated on the throne and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes and where do they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, this Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob. Lord, this is the people that longs to see.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia.
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 morning.
Good morning.
A patient went to see a psychiatrist. And after he was seated, the psychiatrist welcomed him and asked, "We have not met before, and I am not aware of your problem. So, could you elaborate on your issues, starting from the beginning?" "Well, all right," the patient responded. "In the beginning, when I created the heavens and the earth," and the psychiatrist was stunned. Talk about a sense of grandiosity. What the patient, and indeed all humanity, should say instead is this: "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And I need him to tell me who I am and why I am and where I am going. I need to acknowledge that God created me. I need to have a poverty of the spirit." My dear friends, this weekend, we celebrate the Feast of All Saints. Unlike the patient above, the saints are those who have recognized that they did not create the heavens and the earth, or indeed themselves, that it is all God's creation. They are those who recognize that God is the source of their lives, and that it is He who leads them from the nothingness of humanity into the light of God's grand design. Now, for many of us, the concept of sainthood is at best an elusive idea, an impossible concept. But we tend to see saints as a people set apart from the rest of us. However, the very point of Christian message is that we must identify with the saints, for it is by imitating them that we can live out our Christian life more effectively. Perhaps part of the difficulty in identifying with the saints might come from the fact that most of the saints we hear or read about have led spectacular or very heroic lives. It is for this reason that the church today sets apart this day to recognize all the saints, not just those whose heroic stories we read about. And so, today is the day for us to honor the saints, all of the saints, including those who have been canonized, as well as all the other unknown heroic servants of God, many of whom we may know personally, some of whom will be members of our family. But there are those who have not made it on the church's official list of saints. Now, in the gospel reading today, as part of the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus presents us with the Beatitudes, a set of 9 guiding principles to guide us on our own journey to sainthood. The first of these Beatitudes says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs." My dear friends, this first beatitude is a required condition for sainthood. For the one commonality found in all the saints, as they exercise their various charisms, be they charity, chastity, love, martyrdom, and so on, is the possession of a poverty of the spirit. This is because the saints are those who have recognized that God created the universe for a purpose, and that the paramount wish of God is that his will be done. As we read in Genesis, though heaven and earth may pass away, my word will stand. And as Jesus himself teaches us to pray in the Our Father, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. My dear friends, by virtue of our baptism, all of us, both clergy and laity alike, are called to allow the will of God to prevail in our lives. We are all called to be saints. As St. Paul tells us in Ephesians 2:19, you are no longer strangers or sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. But truth be told, it is not always going to be easy for us to reach sainthood. For as Jesus points out, though the spirit may be willing, the flesh is weak. And though the human mind has the capacity to do great good, as Jesus tells us, these things that I do, you can do even more. It is also true that the human mind has the capacity to do great evil. For within the human mind exists a duality. On the one hand, we have the ego, which as a result of our fallen nature seeks to reject the will of God and to elevate itself to the status of a god. However, and thankfully, we also have the indwelling spirit of God, the Holy Spirit. The ego seeks to serve itself solely, and it is when we listen to it that we do things contrary to the will of God, becoming avaricious, contentious, manipulating, covetous, calculating, believing that we are better than everyone else, or worse, that we are a god. The Holy Spirit, on the other hand, seeks to remind us that we are the beloved children of God, that God does not seek to impose his will on us, but rather speaks to us in a still, small voice. When invited, the Holy Spirit seeks to impact in us an ability to see and to accept the will of God in our lives, allowing us to live according to the laws of God. This, in turn, will create a peaceful heart in us, giving us a serene disposition no matter what life throws at us, and thus leading us into our own sainthood. And so we find that our attitudes in life depends very much on whom we are listening to. The Holy Spirit, or like the patient in my story, our own ego. But we alone can make that choice. But dear friends, today's gospel is calling us to have a poverty of the Spirit. It is reminding us that God is in control of the events in our lives as he seeks to establish his kingdom on earth. It is reminding us that the kingdom is bigger than us, and that it is not only beyond our efforts, but beyond even our imagination. It is telling us that we are workers, not the master builder, and that the way we can become more effective workers is if we have a poverty of the Spirit, which then will enable the Holy Spirit to work in us and to lead us back to God. Let us pray today that all of us may have the grace to listen to the gospel message. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the light of glory to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, blessed be God, who is all good. May this God of blessedness give us what we need to follow in the path of the divine Son.
That all members of the church continue to turn to the saints in heaven as examples of those living holy lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis, Archbishop Blair, all the priests, deacons, and religious may through their lives and ministries proclaim the truth of God's love for all. We pray to the Lord. That all the people of the world share in the blessings of creation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer in times of great distress may find strength with the help of our prayers and the graces of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That each of us here at Sacred Heart Church faithfully model our lives after those of the saints who have gone before us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve our country, those who have died, and those who suffer in any type of pain, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those we pray for in a special way today, the repose of the souls of Alma and Roe LeBrock, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions written in our book and those in our hearts. For these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Holy God, you sent your Son to show us the way to blessedness. Hear these, our prayers, that one day we might fully share with all the angels and saints in your everlasting life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, O Lord, God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that, just as you believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church, for whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Leona Blair, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and especially today, Alma and Wo Labrecht, Father Annick Francois Joseph, Mackenzie Seristal, Floristal, Paula Di Giovanni, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us. All we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other some sign of the peace of Christ.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak foreign lands and all. the burning flames. You shall not be harmed if you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side. Know that I am with you through it all. Be not
let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your sayings, we implore your grace so that, coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquets of our heavenly homeland. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Christmas in November has started. We are accepting donations of warm men's hats, gloves, socks, and scarves for men at the McKinney shelter. This Friday is our first trip of the year to the McKinney shelter. We still are in need of ham and vegetables. Please call the parish office if you can help. This Saturday at 11 a.m., we invite you to join us as we celebrate a special Mass for those who have died this past year. Please contact the parish office if you have a name you would like added to our list, or if you have a picture you would like to add to our All Souls Corner.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do your prayers of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander throughout the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.